Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Derek, and today's episode is brought to you by my very own Graphic Design Bootcamp 1 course. I'm gonna sponsor it myself because I can do that. Links below for the best price if you're interested in becoming a graphic designer and you wanna learn more about it. Hey, what's up, everybody? Today, I've got something fun for you. Basically, I'm working on my portfolio. I've been talking about that the last few videos. And if you want to follow along, you can download the assets below. There's a Dropbox link where you can grab all of the assets and you can keep them, have them, borrow them, steal them, whatever you want to do. Basically, what we're doing today is we're creating a business card mock-up, but we're taking it one step further. So if we look at my screen right now, we're taking this image that I bought from Adobe Stock. And we are going to be, and when I bought it, I thought it was a template, but really it was just one flat JPEG. So what I ended up doing with it is creating a mockup that looks like this. So now what I can do is drop in smart objects and they'll update. So for example, if I click in here and we just update the smart object with something else, click save, and we jump back into our original file once it's done saving here. You'll see that not only does it update the image, but it also updates all the image down the side. So it actually looks like these are real printed cards. Okay, so that's going to be what we're doing today. And it's going to be a ton of fun. It's going to be a lot of work, but hang with me. At least you'll see the basic elements of how to do this pretty quick. But if you want to see the full process, you can watch the whole video. Also, don't forget, you can click the button down below to adjust the settings on this YouTube video where you can scrub it fast or slow it down if I go too fast. All right, so let's go ahead and dive in. All right, so the first things first, here is the original Adobe Stock image. And one thing I want to point out that when you go to bring in different artwork, let me just kind of jump in here. We're jumping ahead a little bit. And we are going to open up this business card comp that I downloaded from Envato Elements. If I were to just paste this into Photoshop right now, it comes in as grayscale. And so what's going on here is if I look up in this top tab, I can see that it's a vector smart object and it's in grayscale. So what I need to do, I'm going to delete this smart object, come up here to image mode and change it from a grayscale image down to an RGB color image. Now when I paste things in here, it'll bring in that color. Okay. All right. So let's get to work. What we're going to do is I'm going to jump over into Illustrator. And again, I downloaded this business card. If I jump back over into my web browser, I'm at Envato Elements and I search for business card template and just downloaded this one real quick. So I've got this and I'm going to open it up in Illustrator. And what I can do now, I don't want both the front and the back in one file. So I'm just going to make a new document real quick. We'll go to file, down to new. And I'm just going to physically make this 2.5 inches by 3 inches tall. That's a standard business card size in the US. We'll click create. And you'll notice in the original document, they've got bleed. And we're not going to do a bleed on this for right now. We're just trying to mock it up. So I'm going to come back over here and just grab everything. Hit command C to copy. Jump back over here and we're going to paste it in. And obviously I didn't set up my file right. So let's take a look at that real quick. Oh yeah, my bad. Business cards are 2 inches by 3.5 inches. There we go. That's looking better. Perfect. And I'm going to save this as business card front. And let's drop this in with the rest of our project files. Okay, so there's our front file, and let's do that again for our back. I'm actually going to just delete this. We're gonna grab this side, copy it. We're gonna paste it in here and align everything. And then I'm gonna hit Command Shift S or go to File Save As, and we're just gonna call this business card back. Hit save, there we go. So now we've got our business card files ready. And I'm going to jump back into Photoshop, into this document that we're going to be building over. And let's just go ahead and save this. Command-Shift-S. And we're going to save this as business card mockup. All right. Change it to a Photoshop document. We'll embed our color profile and click save. All right. So now we're ready to begin creating this mockup. And what I want to do is go to File. And I'm going to come down to place. And there's two ways that we can be placing this right now. We can place this as an embedded file, or we can place this as a linked file. So if it's linked, what's going to happen is, let's go ahead and grab that business card front that we made. We'll place it. We'll grab this front and we'll throw it in there. And now I can scale it up, do whatever I want. And if I go to the layer over here, we can see it's got this little chain link icon. And what that means is if I double click, it's actually, let's go ahead and activate these fonts real quick. So what it actually did is it linked to the original Illustrator file. So for example, let's just say we change this color to something obvious to see it, and I save this and I close it. Two things will happen. One, yes, it'll update in our Photoshop document, but if I go back to the original file we made, the Illustrator file, it actually updated that file, okay? So if I were to go back into Photoshop, and this time I'm going to File, Place, Embedded, and we throw that exact same file in there with the yellow, we'll place it, click OK, and now all the data for this file is actually embedded into this Photoshop document. So up here, you'll see the icon's a little different. So the one below, it's got the chain link, that means it's a linked file, this guy right here. But this new one we just dropped in is actually a smart object, so it retains everything. If I double click in there, it still opens up Illustrator. So I'm in Illustrator, and you can see that the file name looks the same. Everything looks the same, but let's change this color to something else now. We'll click Save. And you'll notice if I come back into my original file in Finder, it still looks yellow, right? But if I jump into Photoshop, that card updated. So all that to say, as you're working with smart objects and you're working with linked objects, just pay attention, because let's say you were to send this file off or save it somewhere and you had linked files in here, if those don't come with it, that data will get lost and it won't load. So just pay attention to your links, basically, is what I'm trying to say. So what I'm going to do is actually delete this layer, because I want to work with the embedded image here. Now, this is already a smart object. Let me just try something real quick. Okay, we're good. What I'm going to do now is just hit Command T to get my free transform tool, and we are just going to skew or scale this into place, however you want to look at it. So basically, so I'm going to hold down the control, actually it's the Command key, I'm sorry, on a Mac, and then I get these double white or the single white arrow. So I'm going to click, hold Command, and then click and drag to skew this into place here. And you'll notice that, okay, so it's not skewing the way I want to. So what I'm going to do is step back to the original. I'm going to right click and convert to smart object. Now it's already a smart object, but we're doing it again, basically putting it into a shell. So I'm going to hit Command T this time. And now what I can do is it will let me skew the image into place. All right. I hope that makes sense. Basically, I just wrapped it in a shell of another smart object, so that way I could manipulate the artwork the way I want it to. So we're just going to get it close here. Now, the way this shadow works, everything looks pretty good right now. And one thing you'll notice, if we come back to the original sample, I've got this drop shadow below it here. So that helps it look real, because if I just masked out the next card, there wouldn't be any shadow on top of it. So we're going to come back and add some shadows and do some things to make it look real. But for right now, we're just getting our smart objects in place. So now I'm going to come back to File, down to Place Embedded. And we're going to grab that back design. We'll click Place. We'll throw it in there. And now sometimes when you place stuff, it will include the transparent pixels around it. So it'll look like you'll see the bounding handles all the way out here. And again, by wrapping this into another smart object, it'll make it compress right down to just the pixel data of the card. And it'll make it so we can skew this into place. So I'm just going to scale this up and get it exactly where I want it to be. Perfect. All right. So now this layer is above this one. So I'm just going to hit Command in the left bracket to just throw it behind. So now it's close. It actually looks pretty good, but the sides of the cards are not going to be black. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab this card. I'm going to hit Command J to jump cut another copy in front of it. And I'm just going to drag this down to the bottom. We're going to bring this layer down below the next one. So now we have two cards, but it doesn't quite look right. So let's go ahead and add a drop shadow to this. So we'll come down here to the Effects tab, and we're going to go to Drop Shadow. And we're just going to add a really small, it's like 2 pixels, 1% spread, and 5 pixel size. set to multiply, black, and 82%. So there's my settings for this drop shadow. I'll click OK. And now what I can do is I'm going to apply this drop shadow. I'll hold on the Option key to click on this Effects and drag it up here. So that way both layers have this drop shadow effect. Now I'm going to Command click both of these and hit Command G to group them together. So that way what I'm about to do, everything stays in this little group. So I'll click on the bottom stack and I'll hit Command J to make another copy. And now I'm going to hit the up and down arrow keys a little bit. Command J, hit the up and down arrow keys. And I'm just going to repeat this process over and over until it looks right. Now, you could also, instead of hitting the up and down arrow keys, hit the shift and then the up and down arrow keys. And what that's going to do, anytime you hold down shift, it's going to go by 10 pixels instead of just 1 pixel. So basically, I'm just going to Command J to jump cut, shift and the up arrow, and I'm just making a ton of copies of this same thing over and over and over and over. Oh my goodness, you guys. So you can see how this is going. All right, so now what we need to do is make this look better, because as is, it's headed the right direction, but it's not quite there yet. So we are physically going to drag these copies in place and just kind of nudge them around and maybe even click on one of these layers and then get the free transform and just kind of pivot them just a little bit. Because if this was really in a stack, it would not be super perfect, okay? So what I want you to do, if you're following along, is just continue this process until you get it to look like this finished one here. That's basically all I did to get this effect, okay? So I'm not gonna worry too much about finishing this out for the sake of time, but you get the effect of how this works. So that's why I put this in this group first, so that way I have full control over that entire stack and just having, instead of having a mess of layers, okay? So the next thing we need to do is create a little drop shadow. And it's tough to see on this blue background. All right, so what I'm gonna do real quick is just double click in the smart object, and I'm going to just fill it with this blue color just so I can see. There we go. Just so I can see the shadow that we're about to work with as we come back. Let's see, there we go. All right, great. So now you can see that everything's blue. And if this card were really sitting on top, there would be a drop shadow casted on top of this. So here's how I'm gonna do that. There's a lot of ways we could do this. The quickest and easiest would be just to throw a drop shadow on this layer, which is great, you know, whatever, that's fine, that gets me close. But it doesn't look quite right because the shadow would not just be hovering around the edge like that. So we're gonna go ahead and delete this drop shadow. And I'm gonna physically make a new shadow. So I'm gonna hold down the Command key and click on this layer to get a rectangle. I'm gonna hold down the Command and click on the new layer icon down here to get a new layer below that card. If I'd let go of the Command and just clicked on it, it would throw it above. And now I'm gonna hit the letter D to get my color palette reset to black, and then I'm gonna hit Alt or Option and hit Delete to fill it. So what I just did, let's go to Select, down to Deselect. If I turn off this layer, I just basically made a black rectangle in the exact same shape as this card. So what I'm gonna do now is go to Filter, down to Blur, down to Gaussian Blur, and you're gonna have to mess with how much blur you add depending on the resolution of your image. We'll leave it like that for now, and I'll click OK. So if I turn this back on, you'll see it looks like a drop shadow. We're gonna come back to the shadow layer. I'm gonna change the blend mode to multiply, and we're gonna scrub it down, the opacity down to, I don't know, maybe like 30%. Now here, what we're about to do is the reason why I created a separate layer. So I'm gonna turn back on this top layer so I can just see the business card in relation to everything else. I'm gonna click back on the shadow layer, and I'm going to get my free transform tool. And this time I'm going to click up here in the options bar with the free transform selected to actually warp the shadow. So I'll click on this, and now I've got this grid where I can click and drag and kind of warp. At an extreme sample, you can see how far we can warp this shadow. So I just wanna bend it out a little bit across the top of this and maybe tuck in the shadow, because you can see, depending on where the light source is, we're gonna have some different shadows going on here. And I don't want it to be over the top, just enough. By over the top, I mean not physically over the top of the card. I mean, I don't want it to be like so extreme of a shadow that it looks fake, because we've got a lot of other shadows already in this image. So I'm just gonna crunch the rest of this in just a little bit, because I really only want it to stick out on top of this card to help sell the effect. When I'm done, I'm gonna hit return, and I can also add a mask to this layer. We'll turn off this top card. And what I could do is get my brush tool, just a nice soft brush on the mask layer, painting with black. I can just kind of fade out the parts of the shadow that we don't need, just so that way it doesn't bleed over anywhere else in the image. It's still there. If I hold down the shift key and click on this mask, I can bring that back. But by doing that, it really sells the effect that this is in this space with the shadow. And again, this might be a little extreme. So let's go ahead and modify this just a little bit. We're just going to bend it back. So you're just gonna have to play with it. Just personal preference. See what you like. See what fits the best. Maybe even scrub this down just even further, just so it's super subtle, because I feel like the more subtle the effect, the more it really sells it. So now that we've got this business card here, I'm going to go back into that smart object. We're just going to turn that layer off and save it. We'll jump back over into the original mockup here. And again, on this dark blue color, you really can't even see that shadow, but it's there for you as you update and save this for other things. Now, the only other thing we want to watch out for, make sure that when you finish lining things up, we can see here, let's go ahead and close this group, the original stack of images. So one of two things: either get rid of all this and do it over a plain background. So for example, if we just add a new layer and let's grab this color here, and we're going to fill the back with just a slightly darker version of that. Get my gradient tool, put a radial gradient in there, just something subtle. Okay, so if I did this, it would allow me to put this on any color background I wanted, which is great, but we did lose some important shadows. So you'd want to do the same thing that I just did with this top shadow and build out some more shadows down below, just to kind of really help sell the effect. So let's just go ahead and do that for fun here. I'm going to command click on this guy. Let's just fill it with black. Let's go back to our filter, our Gaussian blur. I've heard Gaussian, could go either way, whatever. Pretty sure it's Gaussian. And we're just going to bend this down a little bit, bend it out. And I think that was kind of close. Let's see here. Let's turn this layer off and turn the shadow off. Just kind of see where it's at. And I'm not going to stress about this too much again for the sake of not making this a 45-minute tutorial, but really study those shadows and you can dial those in and create a shadow to where you can create your own background and do everything from scratch here. So what I'm gonna do is turn that shadow off, turn off this green background. The other thing we could do, if we're gonna leave it here, like I was starting to say, is just, you know, pivot these cards and shift them into place to where they actually line up, or at least hide what's happening here, okay? So take your time to get that dialed in, get it looking good. And that is how I would create a custom business card mockup, and you could repeat this for flyers, for envelopes, for, you know, brochures, anything you want to create a physical mockup of something that then lets you swap out the images as you want to update your portfolio. All right, guys, I hope you loved that tutorial and learned a ton. Don't forget, all the assets are linked below if you want to follow along and or just borrow/steal/have that mockup file that I made. You're welcome to take it and use it as your own. Also, don't forget, I have links to the courses below. If this was something that you would love to learn more about and learn how to become a graphic designer, you can check out those links below. And last but not least, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit that bell for notifications for new videos that come out every Wednesday and Friday. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you have an awesome weekend, and we will see you later.